Hope is the love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. So after all our suffering in 2020, it is with hope that we approach 2021. We start the new year with multiple vaccines against the coronavirus being produced and rolled out. We pray for speedy deployment of vaccines. It is our hope that this will allow us to finally put this pandemic behind us. We start the new year with a new government, a new president. We pray that the transfer of power will be a peaceful one. It is our hope that our nation will now turn to addressing the real problems of racial justice and economic inequality, and mark the end of the useless, divisive cultural wars fomented by both the right and the left. We start the new year with a new chapter in the life of our own church. We lift up the relocation for a good city this month, that all might go smoothly, and we would be able to begin worship in the new building on schedule in February. It is our hope that you would open up new friendships for the existing congregation of Redeemer Church and new opportunities for ministry. We continue to pray for the children's pastor that you would bring us the right person at the right time to enable us to raise up and equip a generation of children. We have a strong, dynamic faith. We lift up our church leaders and missionaries and pray that you would give them hope as they attempt to minister in their respective fields during these challenging times, and that you would bless the works of their hands. Finally, we lift up Pastor Joseph this morning as he opens your word to us. May your words flow through him, take root in our heart and minds in a way that will further your kingdom. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, amen.
Have
have a couple of announcements this morning that I'd like to share. Brother Ed mentioned in his prayer, we are relocating by the end of this month. And so our last service at Cornerstone, we are Cornerstone, we're not changing our name. Our last service at Palo Alto would be the fourth week, Sunday of this month. January 31st, Sunday, will be held in Redwood City. So have that in mind. And also, church is giving away church furniture. So you're welcome to drop by church to take furniture from church if you need. Right, Brother Houston? We have a lot of folding chairs, a lot of foldable tables, and bookshelves, and whatever you see, you can take. You're welcome to give donations to church to cover the cost of relocation costs. So, have that in mind, and if you need anything for your outdoor, patio, or outdoor chairs, you can take a lot of the foldable chairs if you want to. So, except for the notes that has take on it, there's a red sticker on it. Don't take that one. Take everything else. Thank you for being with us in heart as we make this transition. We have a prayer service, a blessing prayer service this Saturday at 8 a.m. You know, we don't do this regularly, so this is something that you have to keep in mind. And EM, KM, YM, CM, whatever M, we're all meeting together as church via Zoom to pray for one another and to ask God's favor upon this year. So it is a blessing prayer service, and you can join in via the Zoom link in your bulletin that Brother you sent us last night. So have that in mind, and you're welcome to join us for prayer that morning, this Saturday morning at 8 a.m. Okay. One last announcement is sad news. Our beloved member, Mrs. Mohishin, she has been with us, our church, from the beginning of our church, and she passed to be with the Lord yesterday afternoon, and our hearts are in sorrow with Mr. Shin and surrounding families. So we would you please pray for the Shin family, for them to be comforted by God's comfort, and for all the process, the funeral, and everything to go smoothly during this pandemic. And also, pray for Mr. Shin, for his health. He's an older gentleman, as you might imagine, and he appreciates your prayers and your support in prayer. So, wanted to relay that information to you. Okay, that's that. Let's go into the Word of God. On this first Sunday of the new year, I want to share from the book of Mark, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Let me read these verses from the English Standard Version, and we will enjoy God's message for us on this very first Sunday of the year. Very excited. We're putting a pause on the book of James for this week, and we'll resume next week until the end of the month. But today we look at Mark, the Gospel of Mark, in chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. If you haven't already, bring your Bible or open your apps and read with your eyes and your hearts as I read for us. Verse 1 of chapter 2, book of Mark. And when he, Jesus, returned to Capernaum, after some days it was reported that he was at home, and many were gathered together so that there was no more room, not even at the door. And he was preaching the word to them. And they came bringing to him a paralytic carried by four men. And when they could not get near him because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him, and when they had made an opening, they let down the bed on which the paralytic lay. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Now some of the scribes were sitting there, questioning in their hearts, "Why does this man speak like that? He is blaspheming. Who can forgive sins but God alone?" And immediately Jesus, perceiving in his spirit that they thus questioned within themselves, said to them, "Why do you question these things in your hearts? Which is easier to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise, take up your bed and walk'? But that you may know that the the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins, he said to the paralytic, I say to you, rise, pick up your bed, and go home. And he rose and immediately picked up his bed and went out before them all, so that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, we never saw anything like this. Amen. This is the gospel from the Gospel of Mark. I truly, again, bless you and wish you a happy new year. I'd like to be frank though, right? Not just vain words, but we want to be happy with the new year. We want to be centered.